Greetings, Mark here in for GPA. Hey, I'm going to share with you how I built my entire ham shack for less than $100. Now, when I'm referring to the shack, I'm not referring to the physical location. I'm just referring to the equipment that I needed to get on the air and to accomplish my objectives. Now, not everybody has the same objectives. My objective was to be able to get on the air and to communicate with people locally through some of the local repeaters here, to participate in Aries and Skywarn, and to participate with our local emergency operations here in Marion County, Florida. It's called MERT, Marion Emergency Radio Team, and also to connect to the statewide amateur radio network that we call SARnet. So my objective was to have a good emergency communication backup plan that I could use also to help with disaster relief and local emergency preparedness and recovery. But let's start first with the radio. And you see here, I have the HIROYASU IC-980 Pro that is about a $57 radio shipped if you buy it on AliExpress. Sometimes you can find it for around $42, and then by the time you pay taxes and shipping, it comes to around $57. If you find it listed for less than $40, it's probably a scam. So check the sellers very carefully. I've heard stories of people ordering the radio for around $30, $32. They never get it, but they do get a shipping confirmation that a very large package containing something else was shipped to somebody else somewhere else in the world. And the shipping company says they've done their part and you're not going to get your money back. So I actually paid for mine using PayPal, and it was $57, but PayPal offered me a $50 credit if I would apply for the PayPal credit card. I did. I got the credit. So actually, I paid $7 for the radio. Okay. So next, you need a decent power supply. I'm not counting the cost of this power supply in the deal with the radio because I already had it. I had it for other purposes. I've had it for years, and I use it as a backup system for, when we prepare for hurricanes around here. I charge that thing up and make sure that I can use it to charge up my cell phones. As you see, it's got a USB output, but it also has a cigarette lighter output, a DC 12 volt cigarette lighter output, which works fine for this HIROYASU IC-980 Pro. Is it the 980 or the 970? That's the 980. Okay, the 980. I think I said 970 earlier. That's it. The HIROYASU IC-980 Pro, one of the finest knockoffs that China can produce. If I showed up at my local radio club with this radio, they'd probably laugh me right out of the club. Hey, look, I'm not into DXing. I'm not into contesting. I'm not into logging contacts. I'm not into winning certificates or anything like that. I just want a decent, reliable, inexpensive radio that allows me to get on the air. So this one accomplishes that. By the way, the radio itself came with this DC adapter, this cigarette lighter adapter, came with the radio. Other radios, you got to pay separately for that, so that can increase your cost. Okay, so out the back of the radio, we got the coax running, and you see it's running right over there to the window. And I've got to fix this right here, but we just built this room. It's an enclosed patio, and these walls, believe it or not, they're cinder block filled with concrete. So there's no way I was going to drill a hole through those walls, and I could probably go up to the ceiling and drill a hole up there and run a coax up the wall, out through the ceiling, out through the roof. But my wife wasn't going to have any of that. We just built the room, and she likes it very much. And so I was able to convince her to allow me to run the cable out through the window. And then in order to secure the window and to keep the cold air out, the hot air in, or first vice, I ran this. This is basically pipe insulation that I bought at a local hardware store. And I'm using that to fill the gap, because I don't want that window to crimp that coax. And so I kind of tore a little piece of it open there so I could run the coax through there, but it's not being crimped by the radio, by the antenna, but it does have a little bit of a gap there I need to fill up. And then in order to secure the window, because it won't lock in that condition, I installed in the track here, this is an adjustable curtain rod. I put one on on the bottom and a different one on the top. So that this window, even though it's not locked, it's secure, it's not gonna open. And they also help to keep the window pressed up against that insulation. Okay, let's go outside and look at the antenna. All right, so people ask me all the time, what kind of antenna do you have? And I just say, I don't know. You know, my wife would say, you know, when it comes to technology, I would ask her, what kind of this or that did you get? What are the specs? And she'd say, it's a pretty one. And so that's what I would say. Well, I got a pretty one. Actually, I got a cheap one. I got the cheapest one I could find on Amazon. But this is a vertical trunk mount antenna that I bought on Amazon. And if you can see here, the sun's shining on it. But I actually have it mounted to the roof on the flashing, which is metal. So I believe it's creating the proper ground plane. It seems to. And then I got the coax running down, and it's going in through said window down there. One of these days, I'm going to secure that coax so it's not just flapping in the breeze. But how much did I pay for that? I paid $37.99 for that antenna. It is a 144/430 megahertz with a PL259 through 239 UHF female connector and antenna mount, 77R station antenna for dual band VHF UHF ham mobile radio. $37.99 between that antenna and that 25 watt HIROYASU that I have inside. I am able to hit all of the repeaters that I want to hit. By the way, I live in an HOA. I'm not in violation of any HOA rules with that. But everybody tells me that I've got a great sounding signal. That HIROYASU's got some great features, including noise cancelization. So it comes out really great. And since I've got at least a dozen repeaters in my area in less than 30 miles, it's doing great. And I'm also, I can monitor a repeater out of Gainesville that's 40 miles away. Although they say that my transmission on it's a little bit sketchy. So all total, I spent less than $100 on my shack. And it accomplishes my objectives. It works for me. You might laugh, but you know what? If you spent thousands of dollars on your shack, I'm laughing at you, because what you spent is not what I need. What I have may not be what you need. But if you have the same objectives I do, don't spend the grocery money on your hobby. To me, it's even more fun seeing how I can do this and get by with the least amount of money. Okay, that's it for now. N4 GPA 73.